Hello and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 2013 Springfield Hills with Mr. Talking Panda Donkey. Mushroom. See, we said that together.
Yeah.
We're on the same wavelength. Well,
here
not
I'm
really.
I'm standing and Panda want to cut my hoof.
Yeah, I want to run him over. Nah, I wouldn't run him over much.
Would you like to stretch my teeth?
I'd like to get their moves and time together though.
We have money now. What can I spend it on?
We not got that much money. Get your little mitts off. Well, how am I gonna get through here?
And as you can see, our little accident. If you remember from last episode, we had accident, but
who had accident?
This tow truck here made everything good. A Russian tractor. Can't live with them. You can't live without them. Okay, so.
I mean, what he was saying is, he had an accident. I come to help him. Then he totally wrecked me.
I can live with that.
And we called in the Russian, whoa, get around the corner. Didn't the new combine? That's alright, it's only a scratch. Bit of spray paint.
If you're thinking and asking us, that is not old tractor, old harvester, but yes it is. It is from 1996. When you watch the description.
It's nice. So we press 5 to open the grain tank, don't we?
Yeah. Oh, I got the header myself.
Do you want Anne putting that on, or...?
No, on my way. With the header on the trailer.
We was going to have a look to see if this header hooked up to the internationals, weren't we?
Yeah. But I didn't have time with that, so...
What do you mean you didn't have time?
Someone took the header and the harvester before I even had to catch my breath.
No.
No, you can... I can... We have wheat and barley here. I can fix that.
Oh, I'll do this field and then I'll let you play.
No.
You have all the new toys and you never let me have any fun.
It's the old rusty stuff here, Panda, you can have that.
What, you mean that stuff you keep knocking about?
Yeah.
God, I'll tell you what. It's a good job we ain't got a damage mod on here, innit? We'd be bankrupt within about the first episode.
Guys, for Mr. Laughing Donkey.
You gotta laugh, Mr. Donkey.
Ugly laugh.
So, thank you very much, everybody that's been watching our videos, and hope you're enjoying them. And we've never said it before, but if you want to take a different view, you know, you can go to either the channels and open them both up.
Yeah.
And watch them both at the same time.
Yeah.
I say go to Donkey's and watch his. He's better than mine.
Oh yes, he's so good that you can't imagine. Nobel Prize in movie making. We're gonna go and pick up an Oscar for this movie. No. No, watch my pen.
It's because Mr. Donkey has more accidents than me. And he did this map, so it was me. Whoa, who put a tree there? Get a chainsaw, cut it down. Whoa.
And there we start harvest some wheat. And I thought we don't do corn on every field because we only had one corn header, so I was thinking we could do some wheat and barley as well, because we could sell the straw and get some money. We're waiting for great demands.
Yeah, we've got a great demand coming up in a few days' time, haven't we?
Yep. Corn. Demand
for corn,
and obviously there can be wheat and barley great demand coming up after this other great demand. We can sell the wheat right away because we need all money we can get, or we cannot seed again.
Yeah, because
did I say anything about saving money? You get money.
I've got to tie his hoofs. I have. Anybody got any root? I need to tie his hoofs together.
Don't take root, take chains.
He's gone quiet. What you doing? Yes. What you done? What you
trying to? I tried to not break anything. You know, I have weather wheels, so I have to watch my wheel status on this one, or I'm gonna get. I don't want to kill any crops because we need the money. And I need a factor, and I need a cheaper. And I need another perfect card, because this doesn't work.
I need.
I want.
What do you mean, I need? We need money.
Yeah. Here is a tipper.
At least he got rid of that nice fifth wheel trailer.
Yeah, but I was thinking buying that back.
Why? Yeah, I didn't say you can have it back. Just don't expect me to go anywhere near it unless it's with a box of matches.
Some dynamite.
Yeah.
No. I can live with these trailers just for you, Panda. I drive fifth wheel every day.
It is a lovely map, though, this, isn't it?
Yeah. And when we show this movie, I think it's going to be very close to the release of 2015, so...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so Mr. Donkey's already pre-ordered his.
Yes.
Mr. Panda's gonna have to get his thumb out of his buttocks and order his.
You have to clean up the manure on the finger.
Yes.
Order it so we can. I don't know what if we. I don't have any clue if we're gonna continuing Springhill Farm, or we're gonna start doing 15 multiplay. We haven't seen.
Yeah. I mean, we got to see how 15 plays first. It might be a bag of spanners.
Yeah.
And
all the money you have in DLCs and like that on 2013, you cannot only stop playing it.
No. I mean, this is a nice game.
Yeah.
I mean, people moan about...
I think they know that giants, they know that they have, you know, a lot of work to do to live up. People feel that it's worth to, you know, spend the money again on a new game, you know.
Yeah. But for a change, they haven't... Well, I say they haven't. It works out about 30 euros, isn't it? 25 quid-ish, isn't it?
Yeah.
They've not put it at one of these 50 quid games.
Yeah, but at the end, you know, if you buy a 50 quid game, that is one game, you know, like... yeah, but I think most of the game today, they do DLCs because they know that they can, you know, get some extra money out of all the games. If you count together what we have spent, you know, DLCs and dedicated server and everything, this is a quite expensive game, anyway.
Oh yeah, you invest a lot of time in it.
Yeah, and a lot of money as well. I have enjoyed every second. Except for the forest mode then, because it crashed my game.
Ah, but they've just, well, I say just, there's a newer version on the website, so they've updated it. The only thing is they're not telling you when they're updating it. All you have to do is you have to keep looking at the date when they keep re-uploading it. It's gone to the 27th of July, I think it is. The previous version was June.
Yeah.
So
they have any change log what they have done, because there was a lot of issues.
I'm not sure. I haven't really mucked about with it too much. I noticed they've put a Duke's tractor on a beta test as well, which is a bit strange, but they must have something going with giants. But yeah, check out the trailer on Giant's website if you haven't seen 20... Sorry, see, it's 15, not 2015. You get so used to 2013, it's now changed to 15, and it's just Farming Simulator 15. They've dropped the 20 bit.
Okay. I wonder how many people are gonna type 2015 when they do like this in a multiplayer in YouTube movies.
Yeah. But there's, I think they're at GameCon this week, or well, it'd be this week when we're recording this, but yeah. They're going to GameCon so you can have a go of it at GameCon.
Yeah.
Have it on display. Hey, what?
Now, how does it feel, Panda, that now you have to buy two things of the game? Hard to have a family member that want to play the game as well.
Well, yeah, that's when it starts getting expensive. They should do a family pack, really.
Yeah.
shouldn't
you
they?
You know, like they have for when you buy, you know, antivirus and like that, you can have up to 5 computers in your family like that.
Yeah, or there should be an option, you know, to buy 2 copies at a discount rate or something, because...
Yeah.
Just so you can... Whoa, bit of lag there, sorry about that. So you can, you know...
Come on now, Panda, we don't want to have any corrupted recordings.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
But it is computers. If I can do this second time. Whoa! No! Failure. Big failure.
What do you mean, big failure?
I wanted to connect my header to the trailer, but the header fall off. Fell off.
Oops.
Oops, yeah.
Oops.
Oops.
Do you need any help?
Maybe.
Maybe.
We see.
You know.
I tried to...
Last time I helped you, you wrote my tractor off.
Yeah, kind of that now too, because I buried your tractor in the water.
Oh.
But it's still running, and it's clean now.
It's clean now, is it?
Yeah.
Oh dear. So... That's how you clean tractors. You don't get a jet wash, you just plow them into the water.
Yeah, yeah.
Why not?
Salty water, so it gets very rusty nice.
Why not? Works for me. You managed to do it yet?
I am on my last second trying right now. Yes, 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 I made it.
Oh, see? He's a professional, he is. He's a professional.
Yeah, I thought I would play professional farmer. That's more a game for me than this simulator. I try to not tap over to my stuff here. Try to run. Run, Forrest, run! Oh, sorry. I have to close my buttons. So, Panda, what are you looking for now? Is it the logging session or... new physics that they... and the graphic and like that. It's very exciting with the new form.
I'm just excited to see, you know, what they've done with it, to be honest.
Yeah. And if they've done something to, you know, for the modders, what are they gonna do? Only to see when the first map come out in the first months, what it is.
Yeah.
If it's gonna be a lot of, you know, 2013 mods that they only... I think that's gonna be in the start. They're gonna do a lot of, you know, remake of mods for this.
Yeah, the conversions are given, really, aren't they? The people are going to try and convert it straight away, aren't they?
Yeah.
I mean, they tried that off 2011, but it didn't quite work. So it depends how much they've changed it.
And if they have a new game engine and a new graphic engine, I think it can be very hard to, you know, make it look good in here. I think you don't want to, you know, play Farming Simulator 2015 with equipment, with the graphics and physics from 2013.
Well, they say they've improved things, so...
Yeah.
The proof will be in the pudding, so to speak.
And I have already... I think I have told that my biggest wish is that they have a better, you know, the port for steering wheel.
Let's hope they've integrated it.
Yeah.
They're not too bad at listening to the community on what they want, but we will see. Because at the end of the day, they're all on about, it's about making money for them, isn't it?
Yeah.
I know some people are a bit disappointed that John Deere's not there from the off take, but we will see. We've got New Holland. Looks like we've got New Holland big balers. So it should be new bale physics anyway, shouldn't it?
Yeah. And there they can improve a lot. And you know, physics around the animals, that you can't walk through them. If you drive on a cow, they are dead.
Well, yeah, it should be. But it's not released till October, is it? End of.
Yeah. But on their own website it says fall 2014, so I think it can be anytime.
Yeah, you can pre-order it on Steam, but I'm not going to, because I think, well, the last thing, I think it was, Steam was about a week behind or whatever, weren't they, on the release.
Yeah. I don't know, I haven't used that, but I don't know. I don't want people to see what I play.
So here we are, cracking on with the corn. And Mr. Donkey's over there.
I was only thinking about, you know, you buy it on Giant's webpage, it's Giant that, you know, get the money, not any hands between.
Yeah, and
I think Steam takes some, they have to take some money for that, they, you know, distribute the game and like that. I think it's better to buy from company from the beginning. If you have any problems, it's easier, you know.
Oh well, yeah, they, with the 2013 when it first came out, they had synchro problems with Steam and Giant, so hopefully they won't have that problem with multiplayer.
I don't know, but if they're gonna add multiplayer from the beginning or they're gonna, you know,
yeah, well, according to their information that they've put out, it's basically 2013 really, but in an updated version. What they've put out in saying what it can do, the new physics, new gaming, new graphics, you can multiplayer up to 16 people.
Oh, 16 people on this map. It's gonna be 16 pandas and donkeys.
I've not come across a map yet that can handle 16 people comfortably, I don't think.
There is one, you know, the fences, I don't know, spring, what is it called? Belly version 2, fences version 2, I don't know. There is Mr. Duckett and Sharky playing on one map. You know, you have your green and your yellow and your orange and your pink farm.
Yeah.
But it's very hard to put, you know, 16 people together for a long time to play together. If you start on one farm, you want to continue playing on that, and you know, then you have to be there when everyone else is there. Or it's not fun, it, you know, bump people other than and then. Funnier play. I don't know. Sorry, viewers, if I'm munching around. And if we say anything that you don't like, you know, if you like a game, don't take, you know, it's our opinion.
Yeah, it's our opinion. It's, you take it or
it's
leave
what
it.
What we think.
Take it with a pinch of salt.
You know, when 2013 came out, I didn't wonder why I should use that game instead of 2011 until I watched Mr. Panda's board reviews, then I started to like the game.
Yeah.
So it's thanks to Mr. Panda that I am sitting here right now and playing this one.
Yeah. With less money, because I made you buy everything.
Yeah.
The game and the DLCs and...
Yeah.
You know, and steering wheel to play it with.
I had to give away, you know, better stat pack to some people. Well... No.
Yeah.
Whoa, weather wheels.
We will see, Mr. Donkey, what will come. It's a fair way away yet, so we will carry on with Springhill Farm, and...
I think we're gonna carry on with Springhill Farm until we find another nice map. On the next, on 15.
Yeah, because I don't know how many maps it actually you're starting off with this time, whether they're just giving you, because it's a Norwegian map.
Yeah, okay. I thought they would do, you know, Nordic stuff, that's why they added the forest in.
Yeah, but are they going to start off with a couple of maps this time, or just one map, like Hagenstead?
I don't know. I hope they don't do Hagenstead. I hope they have learned something. I liked the map in 2009. Was it that with two rivers?
Hmm.
And a big mountain in the middle, and then you feel around that mountain. Or was it 2011? The in-game map.
2011.
Yeah, I like that. There is a mod map on that one I like very much.
And thanks to all the modders, you know, for providing us with great mods to play this game with. I think, without the modders, Giants wouldn't be pushing 15 as much as they have. It's the modders that have really took this game to the next level, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
So thank you very much, modders.
Yeah, thanks for all the funny... everything from small front weights and like that to big, big maps. And if I have to ask you, Panda, now after, if we want to, you know, after almost 2 years of 2015, what is your all-time favorite map and all-time favorite mod?
Don't know and don't know. I really don't know, actually.
You know, it's quite big when you start to, you know, think about how much mod have I used, what mod have I, you know.
Yeah.
There's everything from this, like, animal status and like that, that is useful in that ways to, you know, tractors and bobcats and rope by Euro tigers and everything, you know, it's quite big. And I say it's you, it's very hard to pick one thing.
Yeah, and this John Deere harvester, I really like, actually.
I think that's one of my biggest candidates to...
That harvester
and this map, I think it's one of my candidates to the best.
It might not be the biggest machine out there, but, you know, in practical use and everything else, it's up there.
And, you know, I tried to avoid that harvester for that big reason. If you have watched Mr. Panda's Let's Play, he used that in the start of Bitswell. You sold the in-game once and used that, and I was thinking that I want to try to find another harvester that worked as well as that, but that header trailer and that function and that price and what you get for that money, it's very hard to, you know, you can change pricing the mods, but that's not the same thing.
But as for I really don't know with a map, because there's quite a few out there that are really good maps.
Yeah. And some ways, I think, you know, my opinion, I like small, easy to work with maps. So this Springhill Farm, yeah, and it's, you know, some think that is challenging, like this fences and walls and tight corners and everything, but I like that when it, you know, I'm not the paradise map guy, because I don't want to have, you know, huge fields and, you know, put everything on hide worker and everything. It's funnier to do things as much as you can by your own.
Yeah, I seem to like the odd shaped fields better than just all square.
Yeah.
I think it adds a bit more to it than, you know, having an all square field.
Yeah.
And also, some of the flat maps they're nice, but they're lacking.
Yeah. One other map that I want you to know, good example of good map, is OGF, German version, the remake of Hagenstadt. That main farm they made there with the cows and everything in buildings, and you have, you know, garage to put your stuff in, it was very nice. And I was thinking, if they made a farm with that much stuff on, you know, everything quite, you know, it's concentrated to the farm, I thought it would lag or anything, but it works very nice. And I think, what do you want to see, Panda?
Well,
only the donkey that's talking today, you know, that's why I have got my name.
That's, you know, your opinion's just as good as mine, matey.
Yeah.
So, good on you.
So, after that mulching around, I think next episode is going to be quite donkey and a talking panda.
I don't think so. I don't think so.
But viewers, we have reached the 30-minute limit.
Yes, it's time to say goodbye yet again. It comes round so quick and we have so much fun. And it's all for you lot.
And if you have any ears left, I want to thank you for watching this episode and take care, and we see you soon again.
Yep, take care for now. See you next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye.